Bachukudi, let's move on to our next story. Now, the Inspector General of Police, Ibrahim Idris, yesterday ordered the Assistant Inspector Generals of Police and State Commissioners of Police in the North to arrest and bring to book those behind Tuesday's three-month eviction notice that was sent to Igbo people in the northern part of the country. Now, he also charged various state police commands to begin a manhunt for those who were beating the drums of war across the country, saying, quote-unquote, anybody, individual or group, that attempts to prevent any Nigerian from carrying out his or her daily activities, the Constitution vests in us the responsibilities to ensure that those guys are stopped by all means. How do we take this story?
Now, the truth is, in Nigeria, we all have the rights and the freedom to congregate or associate, so long as it is not, you know, inimical to progress and development, and it doesn't in any way affect peace in our society. I always insist that, see, you cannot beat a child and ask the child not to cry. There is inequality in Nigeria. There is injustice in Nigeria. There's a lot of bias and unfairness in Nigeria. But this is what I always say. I don't classify this into ethnic or religion. No. I say it is all politics. Because you have a group of people who would protect their interest and do all that they can to perpetuate themselves in power, whether the friend that is helping him or her achieve that aim is Igbo, Yoruba, Hausa, Calabar, or any part of Nigeria. We just discussed the first story about governors or states receiving allocation now. Have we ever seen any country, any state in Nigeria here, where the governor is from Ghana or the governor is from Madagascar? In fact, it's really going to be very, very hard in certain parts of Nigeria to have a governor from another part that is not from the state. Look at what is happening to Bianca Ojukwu. So now we have state governors who preside over the affairs of their state, who receive allocation from the federal government, and who do nothing in return. Now, this stokes the fire of anger, frustration, agitation. And that is why you have people coming out to say, we are not happy to be part of the entity called Nigeria, and we want to have our own. But we need to ask ourselves the simple truth. People are going to, for as long as it pays them, they would continue to create problems in the society for their best interest, which is always political, as against the interest of the collective and the generality of the people. Now, what Nigerians must do is look beyond all these issues. And like I said, you cannot beat a child and ask the child not to cry. People who come out and agitate have valid points in their assessment of a particular situation. What the government must do, seeing that your constituency is the entirety of Nigeria, is to create a balance in society so that certain people will not feel marginalized or segregated. Now, this sit-at-home order, saying people should sit at home and not come out, you can express yourself in any way you deem fit. You can, you know, express your grievances in any way you deem fit. But do not begin to create problems for other people. Do not, you know, try to undermine the rights of other people. So if the Inspector General of Police is saying we are going to ensure and protect people, it should be done in the way that conforms with the law. If certain people say that they are not happy with the situation and they want to sit at home, so long as it is within their rights to express themselves, they should do so. But the bottom line is, if we want our democracy to thrive, there must be equity, fairness, and justice in society. To enjoy more of this, our Ogbonge videos when you just watch, press this button to subscribe on top of our YouTube page. You go love her.